Hi Red Team, I'm Sam, joined by Wally from the AMD Community Management Team. We're excited to be building an AM5 gaming rig today for Wally with our friends from MSI, Dalton and Cliff.
Yeah, and today we're going to be showing off how to build for the AM5 platform.
And I think Wally, you and I will be tag teaming this build for you. Is that right?
Yeah, and I'm super ready to get started. I have to confess, I haven't built a new rig in probably 10 or so plus years. Okay. So a little nervous, but I'm happy to have you here. And I think we're both lucky to have Cliff and Sam as our wonderful assistants in case they need to step in. But yeah, just super stoked.
And one more thing before we get going, guys. If you haven't yet, join the Red Team community and our Discord server where you can share pictures of your rig, their specs, your gaming adventures, and make new friends.
I think we're ready to get started.
Let's do it.
Let's go.
Cool.
All right, Wally, can you tell me a little bit more about the CPU that we have here today?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm actually really excited for this because, like I mentioned earlier, I haven't built a rig in like 10 plus years, so I kind of missed that 5800X3D train. Mm-hmm. I know for the longest time that was the latest and greatest on AMD's side, and now what we have here is the Ryzen 7 7800X3D. So the next step in that line of X3D products, and I'm stoked for it. Just like its predecessor, I mean, it's got some great features here. We've got 8 cores, 16 threads, 4.2 gigahertz base clock, up to 5.0 gigahertz boosted. So that's really awesome. And so one of the biggest changes that AM5 processors introduced, that AMD will use an LGA, LAN grid array socket, instead of a PGA, which is a pin grid array, for AM5. This is really cool because it's the first time that will be used in mainstream systems. And with these new 7000 series CPUs, they don't use pins anymore. The pins are now in the socket. So I'm really excited for that. And then also, it being an X3D CPU, the big hype is 3D V cache, right? Mm-hmm. And so this 7800 X3D processor here has 96 megabytes of L3 cache, which provides additional temporary storage, allowing the CPU to store much more info than it would normally have access to, practically eliminating latency in that process.
I'm going to go ahead and install the CPU right now. So I'm just going to go ahead, push down on this pin right here, lift up, and then I see a little arrow on the plastic CPU socket cover. So I believe we'll just need to match that arrow with the arrow on the CPU itself. I'll go ahead and lift up. You want to be careful when installing the CPU on this type of socket, because if you, let's say, drop the CPU on the pins inside the socket, it's going to be a little bit more difficult to repair, and it's just not going to be a fun time.
No, I can see why you're a little nervous. Yeah, there. I would be too. I'd rather you than me doing this, so I appreciate you here, Dalton.
Okay, go ahead and push down. Might need a little bit of force. As normal, and if you've installed it correctly, this cover should just pop out automatically.
Applause. Surgical, Dalton. Surgical.
So the next step in building, I think we could just go ahead and install the memory if you want to give that a shot.
Yeah, absolutely.
So while Wally is unpacking the DDR5 memory, there is a little diagram on the motherboard itself on which channels should be populated. So if you're using two sticks of memory, it shows to use this channel right here and this channel right here.
Okay, so yeah. In this iteration, we're looking at the second one and the fourth one?
Yeah. So we'll just go ahead and unlock them for you. One thing that I do first is I kind of just line it up to see if that socket or that key kind of lines up, because it only goes in one way. You don't want to force it in the wrong way, because you're going to damage either the RAM or the slot itself.
I totally see what you're saying here.
Yeah. You don't need to push it in all the way. You could just like slowly lower it, see if it lines up. And then what I would do is I'll take two thumbs and like try to push down on the sides for an even, I'll hold the motherboard for you. You're good. I know it feels scary.
I'm
terrified
right now.
It takes more force than you imagine. Oh, that's good. Oh, two clicks.
I think we got two clicks.
Yep.
I see the notches in.
Yep.
This was always the part I feared the most back in the day when I built my first rig, because I was terrified of snapping the ramps to memory sticks.
I think that's secured in nice and
good.
Yeah, it looks locked in.
Awesome.
We're past the most nerve-wracking part. I think we're just going to go ahead and get set for the next section, and we'll check back in with you in a little bit. We're almost done with this PC build. We've gone through the trouble of putting the motherboard in, the liquid cooler, cable managing the PC, but we just need the final piece right now, and that will be the graphics card. Wally, can you tell me a little bit more about what we have?
Yeah, so obviously, like I mentioned earlier, we've got a Ryzen 7800X 3D in there for the CPU, and what better way to combo that than with an AMD Radeon RX 700 XT. So that's what we're working with today. This is actually one of the first times I've actually been able to open a box, so this is beautiful. I love the presentation here. Really excited to use this. You know, it's got 20 gigabytes of VRAM in here. It's got four display ports, two HDMI 2.1, and then a USB-C port as well. And like I said, it's just really sleek. I think our reference cards look really nice.
Yeah, I think that's the first time I've ever seen a reference card in person, and it is absolutely stunning. Let's go ahead and get the GPU installed. So I've already gone ahead and removed the PCIe covers on the back of the case, so we should be able to just slide that GPU right on in. Oh, I heard a click. So, okay. You want to go ahead and screw in the graphics card to the case.
Awesome.
GPU is nice and secure. And then last thing to do is just to plug in the PCIe cables.
Awesome.
All right. So our PC build is pretty much done. Right now we just need to hook it up to a monitor and boot into BIOS to make sure that we have the AMD Expo settings on for the memory. We're pretty much done here. We just need to boot into the BIOS, and we even have our mascot here as our good luck charm. So there's one more thing that we need to check, and it's to make sure that this memory kit is running at its rated speed of 6000 megahertz, because by default it doesn't. To fix that, I need to make sure that AMD Expo is on.
AMD Expo stands for Extended Profiles for Overclocking and was developed to allow for user-friendly memory overclocking support of all types of memory, giving users like me an easy path to improve gameplay. AMD Expo has opened AMD's customers to our preferred memory manufacturers, like the G-Skill memory that we used in this build.
So as you can see right now, we're back into the BIOS, and the DDR speed right here in the top left corner says 6000 megahertz, so it's running at the rated speed. By default, it was running at 4800 megahertz.
Awesome. And with that, I think we're finally done with the build, Dalton. I'm super excited to take this rig home and finally enter the modern era of gaming. To you, Cliff, everyone at MSI, thank you so much. I really can't thank you enough.
Dude, this was a lot of fun. I hope you enjoy your new beast of a gaming PC. It's been great working with the Red Team community. I can't wait to see what our next project is. And if you're looking for your next PC upgrade, check out MSI for all your PC needs.
Well, the feeling is mutual, Dalton. We love working with you guys. And until next time, I guess we'll see you all in the Red Team Community Forum and our Discord server.